Whew, so now we are at grand finals here. It is John Choi going up against Shoto's All Day. Now, when we first saw this match, I mean, John Choi just saw right now, firsthand, why Shoto's All Day picks old Ryu versus Sagat.
Right.
So now John Choi is probably like, okay, I think I know what his game plan is.
That's true.
Right? And when we saw this first matchup here, Shoto's All Day never got a chance to do this to John. And John won pretty soundly, so let's see how this goes. And reminding everybody at home, Shoto's All Day has to win two sets of two out of three to take this tournament. He essentially has to knock John Choi in the loser's bracket first.
Yep.
And then defeat him.
So again, John Choi is not going to go with Sagat. He's going to go with Ryu. But this time, Shoto's All Day goes with new Ryu. And again, he misses the safe jump timing. I don't think he's gotten that more than once or twice against Ryu as we've been seeing this. So he's not even going to bother with it there. And kind of playing a little bit too patiently. He was, you know, he allowed John to take control of that situation. And John will take that all day. If you give it to him, he'll take every inch.
But here we go. Oh, great counter there. Oh, he could have jumped strong one hit. But he might not have been close enough for it.
John just neutral jumping. Neutral jump very important for getting over fireballs. Oh, that's it. Oh, I thought he was dead.
But do you see how John Choi slipped that through those two low forwards? He just, right when that low forward was coming back in, he threw another one before the second low forward could tag him in the legs first.
Oh, nothing. It's a big opportunity for Shoto's All Day. He missed it, and now John Choi with more meter, which is important, more life.
That's so crucial for those Shotos to just do that neutral jump. And if you see, they throw the jab fireball to do the air hurricane to get over it.
And now this is exactly where Shoto's All Day did not want to end up. He put himself in here, into the corner, against John Choi, the man with perhaps the best fireballs in the whole country.
Ooh. See, now the interesting thing is you saw John Choi walk into a couple of fireballs there. That didn't bother him at all. In fact, he would rather take those fireballs and not lose the positioning than to think about a way to block that or try to jump over it or something like that. He was okay with taking those fireballs. It dropped him down to lower life, but he had the positioning.
So John Choi is one game away from taking this whole thing. Oh, that's big. And he knocks Shoto's All Day with a ton of life lost into the corner. Nice. John, oh, he hurricanes himself out. And then knew the high block was going to come. Now Shoto's All Day was super, but he didn't get to use it. Pressed a little bit too hard on the fireball game.
Round two, fight.
One round away for John Choi. For winning his long trip to San Francisco.
Yeah, well, it'd be a great moment for him. And I, honestly, I don't think that the top 25 would have been, or that the finals would have been the same without somebody like John Choi in there.
In fact, it was interesting. They tried to give him a free spot in the Tournament of Legends, and he refused it. He said, I am qualifying for it myself.
Right.
Oh, wake up. And that's here. Comes with the super. One chip.
That's
what a great air
hurricane.
Oh,
he didn't get the super. He just got down toward jab.
And that's it. Oh, no, it's 3 out of 5. Oh, never mind. Okay, sorry, my bad. Those guys looking at me like,
yeah,
Shoto's All
Day's
like, no, not quite. No one told me they went to 3 out of 5.
Yeah, we probably know less about the rules as the commentators than the players or anybody else watching.
Ricky Ortiz is just laughing at
Get
me
out of
right
here, Ricky.
Now, dude. He is laughing at me so bad. Oh, man. I bet you the whole room could hear me say that, dude.
You yelled it pretty loud, man.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, I thought it was over, too. I'm glad that it wasn't my voice that was projected. Great spacing
awesome.
Again from John Choi. You see how he was just standing there? He knew exactly where he was and that he didn't need to do anything but wait for the jump and get the stand strong.
Dude, if John Choi wins this, I'm just going to let you talk.
No, it's all you. It's all you. Right. Yeah, redeem yourself. Okay, this is a bad situation now for Shoto's All Day. He does have the super, but he's in a bad situation on the screen.
Ooh,
okay, this is a start for him.
Yeah,
he's got to make this one work. And he just stays in front.
Oh, see that short hurricane? Avoid it.
And now there's the super.
Okay.
Almost death. Yeah,
and that's it.
Range.
That's it. John Choi takes it. You can take away his appendix, but you can't take away his heart. John Choi. Grand finals winner here for Super Turbo. Congratulations.
Yeah, great job to John. Like I said, I really don't think that this finals would have been the same without somebody like John Choi.
Still rocking that old Ma stick, too. Mm-hmm. You know, he has not adapted to those modern square gate TE sticks. So.
Right, American style parts since early 2000s. Ma sticks made by some dude in his garage. and he went when he walked off the stage just now.
Uh-huh.
He looked like he was a little bit in pain there.
Dude, he's having trouble getting up here.
Oh, wow. You're a champion.
Good job, sir. Good job.
Yeah, that's impressive because he physically looks like he is about in noticeable pain. He ran through the whole tournament in winners. He was never reset, never sent to loser's bracket.
Yeah, that's
odd.
He
took the whole thing.
It's very odd because the John Choi is going into loser's bracket in first round and still winning the tournament.
That's right. That's right. So we mentioned this before. We've said it a few times. But as opposed to the other qualifiers where only the top one makes it to the grand finals in Super Turbo. In this tournament, the top two made it. This is different than the others.
Yeah, so Shoto's All Day will be going
to
San Francisco as well.
That's right. So it was John Choi, the very old school guy, long time, been one of the best in Super Turbo. Shoto's All Day, you know, I don't know how long he's been playing, but I've only known him as a competitive tournament player for relatively recently.
Yeah.
And same with Ultra Combo. Not sure when he started playing, but as far as him going to major tournaments, relative recently too. So I think that's really cool that we have, you know, represented both the old school of Super Turbo and kind of the new resurgence in Super Turbo as well, being represented in the grand finals in San Francisco.
No, it's very cool. It's good. Dude, so the grand finals on December 8th are just going to be amazing. Like, the pedigree of players there. And remember, again, it's not an open tournament, this December 8th tournament. It is only the qualifiers, the people who have won all these qualifying tournaments. And then, basically, what's going to happen, that means, is that we have nothing but the top players for every game. So we are just going to see high-level play like you can't even imagine on December 8th from around the world. I mean, like, even in Street Fighter 4, we had Breno Fighters, the Cammy player.
Who did really well.
Yeah, who took the tournament. So we're going to see these players, you know, that a lot of people haven't seen yet and everyone heard of. And just giving all these guys a chance to make their names and such. And, you know, from everybody who went to Brazil, I know Hans was talking about this and Combo Fiend talked about it. They just said it was just the most hype thing that they could possibly imagine. They just said, like, it was just crazy over there.
Yeah, so, I watched it. It was good. They were into it. And, okay, so now we're done with Super Turbo, as you just saw. Congrats to John Choi and Shoto's All Day. And we're going to take a short break of about 10 minutes and come back with Street Fighter III Third Strike.
Yep.
And get those going. See you in a bit.